request to the next speaker, Professor Bimalendra Kumar, to speak on Pratitya Samutpada.
Most respected Bhikkhu Sangha, Chairman of the session, Professor Pradeep Gokhale, Vice Chancellor Professor Nuang Samtinji, Professor S. R. Bhatt, Professor Ameshan Tiwariji, Professor Kamal Giri, Professor A.P. Jambhaketkar, and other distinguished delegates coming from the different parts of the country. It is indeed a matter of great pleasure for me to present my paper. I am going to present my paper on the significance of law of dependent origination in Buddhist art and thought. Since last 2 days, two papers have been, you can see, discussed on the Bhava Chakra. Professor Wangchuk Dorje Negi and Dr. Pimpa Dorje, they have discussed that how the 12 Nidanas or the 12 links, they have been depicted in the form of the art and how they have been expressed in the inscriptions and the, you can say, temples. Today I am going to discuss that how this law of dependent originations, they have been expressed in the stupas or the inscriptions or the terracotta's ceilings. Before coming to the, you can say, main point, law of dependent originations, I will discuss in a very brief manner that what is the Buddhism. Then I will come to the law of dependent originations, then how they have been expressed in terracotta ceilings and the inscriptions. As we know that Buddhism is a psycho-ethical thought and practice, paryatti and patipatti, which takes a being from the state of suffering to the state of eternal bliss. As a paryatti, Buddhism says that a man is the psycho-physical amalgam and suffering is associated with that. And as a patipatti, it says that there is a cessation of the suffering. Buddha also says that I teach only two things, that there is the suffering and there is the cessation of suffering. Dume bhikkhave desemi dukkham cha dukkha nirodham cha. In between that, he prescribed a middle path. As we know, in Dhamchak Pavatana Sutta, it has been said that katma cha sa majjhima patipada tathagatena abhisambuddha chakshukarni anikarni upsamma nibbana sabatati. It has been said that ahime variya thangiko Samma ditthi, samma sankappo, samma vacha, samma kamanto, samma ajimo, samma vyamo, samma sati, samma samadhi. This eightfold path has been expressed in three ways, that is the sila, samadhi and pahya. And the whole teachings of the Buddha has been expressed in one verse of the Dhammapada, that is the sabbapapas akaranam kusalasya upasampada sachit paryodpannam etam buddhana sasaram. Now the whole teachings of the Buddha has been, you can say, considered as a Dhamma. And Buddha also says that I teach the Dhamma only for crossing from one shore of the existence to the another shore of the existence. That he says that kulupam bhikkhave deshemi, that I teach the Dhamma just like crossing from the one shore of the existence to the another shore of existence. Here, Dhamma has been, you can say, expressed in the form of law of dependent origination. As we know that the law of dependent origination is the origin of the states depending on some cause and conditions. There is no self-independent entity. Everything comes into existence depending on some cause and conditions. It is also said that imasvim sati idam hoti, imasvim vasati idam nahoti, imas upada idam upajati, imas nirodha idam nirojati. That if there is this, there is the existence of the this, and if there is not this, there will be no existence of the this. And we know that there are 12 links. They have been explained in the Anulomova Nay and Patiloma Nay. In Anulomna, we know that Abhija Pache, Sankhara, Sankhara Pache, Biyan, Biyan Pache, Nam Rup, Nam Rup Pache, Salayatana, Salayatana Pachaya, Phasso, Phasso Pachaya, Vedana, Vedana Pachaya, Tanha, Tanha Pachaya, Upadan, Upadan Pachaya, Bhav, Bhav Pachaya, Jati, Jati Pachaya, Jaramaran. These are the 12 links, and in just Patilomano, Abhijaya, Nirodha, Sankhara, like that, there are the 32 rooms. Now, these are the 12 links. I am not going to discuss the 12 links in a detailed manner. Much has been expressed by Wangchuk Dorje Negi and Pimpa Dorje. Now, in Mahabhagya, we have the reference that this law of dependent has been expressed in another way. There is a dialogue between one of the five peoples. We know that Panchabhagya Bhikkhu. There is a monk who is called as Assaji. Assaji approaches to the Sariput and Moghlan, and there is a dialogue in between that. After seeing the, you can say, lightning face of Sariput, no, sorry, the lightning face of Assaji, Sariput approaches there and asks that, who is your teacher and what is the ideal teachings of that teacher? Sariputta says that I am just a novice person. I have been newly ordained in the Sangha. I do not know much about that, but whatever I have come to know, I can explain in this very small verse. That he says that ye dhamma hetu pava tesam tathagato aha tesam char yo nirodho evam badi mahasamano. This is, was the verse which was explained by, you can say, Assaji to Sariputta. And this was popular at the time of the Buddha also and after the Mahaparinibbana of the Buddha also. And this verse, ye dhamma hetu pava, was expressed in the stupas and the, you can say, temples. Whatever the Mahabhyaras, they were explained, you can say. So this is the, you can, how this hetu, ye dhamma hetu pava, tesam hetu cha, tathagata aha, tesam cha ya nirodha evam badi mahasamano. So this verse became very much popular, and how they were expressed in the, you can say, epigraphs and the, you can say, inscriptions, I am going to discuss in that. So this is the, I have discussed in a very way that how Patisamujpad has been explained, that how this I have already discussed. Mm-hmm. And this, the 12 links, I have tried to explain that how these 12 links have been expressed in the three forms, that is the Atit, Pachupan, and the Anagat, you can say. So the first two, that is the Abhijja and the Sankhara, they denote, you can say, Atit, and the last one, that is the Jati and Jaraman, they have been expressed in the, you can say, sense of Anagat. And the remaining eight are, have been discussed, you can say, expressed as a, you can say, Pachupan. So these are the three, you can say, prayers which have been expressed. So this is the 12 links I have given. And how from the Jati Jaraman there is a suffering, and from suffering how they have been explained in the verse. If you see that from ignorance abhijja, we are coming to the aging and death, and if there is the suffering, then the saddha starts, then there is the contentment, sukh, and how there is the samatha and vipassana, and how a yogavachar, after performing the, you can say, samatha and vipassana, he can get a state of eternal bliss. That is the, so I am not going to discuss in a very detailed manner. So this yet, dhamma formula available in the epigraphs. This anulom, first of all, we are having the references of that how this ye dhamma hetu pava have been, you can say, engraved in the inscriptions and everywhere. So this, first of all, anulom part of the sutra was engraved in the Kharosthi inscription, sorry, crossed inscriptions at Kurram Bhelli in Peshawar, Pakistan. So this was the first which is available in the first century AD. Unfortunately, I have not got the exact inscriptions of what it has been engraved. And the second, Anulom and Patilom of the Law of Dependent Origination, they have been rendered in Sanskrit and they have been found at Gopalpur and Kasiya in Gorakhpur. So these are the two which are available in the 4th century AD. So these are the two inscriptions and similar finds, Ye Dhamma Hetu Bhava, they are also available in the Devanagari relic casket inscription, a slave from Ratangiri and on the base of the miniature stupas at Tunhuang. Much work has been done by Devila Mitra and other, you can say, historians. Fortunately, unfortunately, I do not have the photograph of these two. Ratangiri Odisha.
Ratangiri Odisha. Is a trailer also in cave number 10?
Yes. So whatever I had tried to, you can say, collect the materials that where this Ye Dhamma Hetu Bhava is available, I have tried to, most of the inscriptions, they are available in Sanskrit. Only in Sarnath, we are having in Pali, mixed with Sanskrit, I will come to the point. So this is the, you can say, there is another inscription which is available at Dhelva Baba. There is a statue of the Buddha, and just below of the statue, there is the, you can say, legend of Sariput and Moglan. I will come to that point later on. So this Dhelva Baba inscriptions, so first of all, we are having the name of the Sariput and Moglan. This is the inscription of the first century AD. And at last, we are also having the name of the Arj Maitreyanath and Arj Basumitra. So if you go through the inscription, that Arj Sariputra, Arj Mahamadugalayana, Ye Dharma Hetu Prava, Hetum Tesam Tathagato, Hadevat Tesam Cha, Hetu Yo Nirodham, Yom Badi Mahasramana, Arj Maitreyanath, Arj Basumitra. So this is the first inscriptions which we are having the name of the Maitreyanath as well as Basumitra. As we are well aware that Maitreyanath was the propounder of the Yogacharya school and Basumitra was the propounder of Vaivhasik school. So this is the inscriptions which we are having that, and at that time, first century AD, it was clear that Mahayana school of Buddhism was developed in, you can say, Nalanda. So this inscription, Dhelva Baba, is commonly known, and this is available in Nalanda, you can. So next, I will come. Yes. So this, how there is a relation of the verse Ye Dharma Hetu Prabha with Sunyata and middle path. So how this Ye Dharma verse is identified with the Dharma Kaya, because all causes and the Dharma, the nature of all things that are produced are empty. This equation, you can, if you go through the verse which is available in the Madhyam Shastra of Acharya Nagarjuna, in the chapter 24th, verse number 18, that Yah Pratit Samutpada Sunyatam Tamprabhukshe Sapragyapir Upadai Praptipas Sev Madhyama. So, this equation of verse, which is, you can say, Pratit Samutpada and the Mahayana doctrine of Sunyata, can be seen in this verse. Now, we are coming to the Sarnath inscription, where Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava is available. This inscription is available in the 4th century AD. And there is a, you can say, a stone inscription, a stone brick inscription, where this inscription is available. In that it is written, Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava, Hetu Prava, Tesam Hetu Tathagato Avocha, Tesam cha yo nirodho eom badi mahasramano. So in this verse, we are having the impact of the Pali original sutra, because here we are having Prabhava. This is the Sanskrit term, but Tesam Hetu Tathagato, this is the, you can say, Pali term which has come here. Again, Mahasramano, this is the Sanskrit, this is the Mahasramano, which has come in the, so this is the, you can say, Pali as well as Sanskrit mixed inscription which is available here. And this inscription shows as the, you can say, Rupakaya as the Dharmakaya, you can say. So how the form of this inscription shows about the Dharmakaya. Again, in this verse, there are the letters Sa, Cha and Ha are the late Kusan form, and but other letters, particularly Ma and Na, are definitely early Gupta. The epigraph must be dated to the 4th century AD. It is indeed significant that this inscription occurs on the back of the stela carved with the four principal life scenes of the Buddha in early Gupta style. Again, this there is another inscription in the identical script which was found by Cunningham from inside the Dhammic stoop at Sarnath. Thus, there was a common practice of putting the Buddha image and the votive stupas, either the relics of the Buddha or the Gatha, of the two law of dependent originations. So this is the, now in the next slide, I am going to discuss that how. That how there is a relation of the Pratita Samutpad with the Buddha. Even we are having in the Majjhima Nikaya, there is a sutra that how Buddha has been compared with the Vidya. So Buddha in the, there is a Bakkali Sutta. In Bakkali Sutta, we have the reference that Buddha said that yo Bakkali, yo Pratisamutpadam Passati, so Dhamma Passati. Yo Dhamma Passati, so Pratisamutpadam Passati. Which means that one who sees the Pratisamutpad sees the Dhamma, and one who sees the Dhamma sees the Pratisamutpad. And again, in the Milind Pahiyo, we are in the same, are having the, you can say, how this, there is a relation between the Pratisamutpad with the will of law, you can say. So now we are coming to the Nalanda Mahabihar inscription. In the Nalanda Mahabihar, we are having the inscription of that is written Sri Nalanda Mahabihariya Bhikkhu Sanghasya. In this inscription, just above that, we are having the this symbol, you can say, this is Nalanda seal available in the Nalanda Museum. So if you see that the wheel is flanked by the two deers, and this wheel represents the law of dependent originations having the 12 Nidanas, and the two deers, it depicts that the symbol of or device of the wheel and two deers depict that this sermon, that is the Pratisamutpad, was preached by the Buddha at Sarnath, and it was, you can say, it became the symbol of the, you can say, center for higher Buddhist education or learning at Nalanda Mahabihar or Jagdal Mahabihar, and we are having so many Sompura Mahabihar. We are having the inscriptions like this, Sri Nalanda Mahabihar Bhikkhu Sanghasya. So here, it also represents the first sermon of the Buddha delivered at Isipatana Migdai. Dhamma Chakra represents the law of dependent originations, having 12 links in Anulom Loy and 12 links in the Patilom Loy. Thus, there are 24 spokes in the Dhamma Chakra. And there are 24 types of Pachyas, which is the law of dependent originations. In Pathanapakaram, we are having the 24 types of relations, technically known as Pachayaj. And these 24 types of Pachayaj or the relations, they are treated as the extension of the law of dependent origination. There are some scholars who are thinking that these 12 Pachayas, they are nothing but the extension of the law of dependent origination, having the 12 links. So again, we are having one inscription near Bodh Gaya. This is called as Ayar Pathri inscription. In Ayar Pathri inscription, it has been discovered just 1 year back. And there is a name of the village which is called as Buddhavan. And it is famous that when Buddha, before approaching to the Bodh Gaya, first he went to Nalanda. From Nalanda he went to Rajgriha. From Rajgir he spent 1 week at this place. This is called as Buddhavan. There was a forest. Now it is called as Buddhavan, and it has been discovered. You can say some of the artifacts which are available in the air inscriptions, it has come to know only just 1.5 year back. So in this epigraph we are having in just above, there is a Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava. It is written, you can say, in Brahmi script. So I am not able to decipher all these things, and I am not able to tell the, you can say, detailed story. Here archaeologist Professor A.P. Jambetkar and others are sitting here. So what is the significance of the elephant here? And we are seeing that two ladies just back of the elephant, and two ladies are sitting here also. Whether this elephant signifies the conceiving of Maya, Mahamaya Devi, or something else, I am not able to decipher it. It is a matter of archaeologist to discover what they are depicting, you can say. Just I am telling here that in the above of the, you can say, stone, it is written Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava. So this is quite you can say, important for the historians to note this artifacts. Again, we have just discussed, there is a name of Bargaon near Nalanda, where we are having two, you can say, brick inscriptions, where the Ye Dhamma, the whole Anulom, Anulom Nay of Patis Mujpad, law of dependent origination, has been depicted, you can say, Brahmi script. It also belongs to, you can say, 1st century or 2nd century AD. So there was we know Sariputta Chaitya. In Sariputta Chaitya, you can say, brick inscriptions have been discovered. There are so many, you can say, brick inscriptions which have been offered from 6th century AD to the 10th century AD. And above that, we will find that how the Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava and Abhicha Pache Sankhara, two, you can say, Jati Jaramaran, they have been depicted in the brick. The brick is in a, you can say, damaged form, we are seeing, but it has been safely kept in the Nalanda Museum. So I have taken the photograph and just I have shown you that how Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava has been, you can say, depicted in this brick. Again, I have taken the photograph of that, you can say, from my own camera, which is depicting like this, you can say. It is more clear than the previous one, which has been taken from the Nalanda Museum. This is exact, you can say, the photograph which I have taken in Nalanda Museum. The original, you can say, the Nalanda inscription, which the fill which is flanked by the two deers, and the inscription shows that Sri Nalanda Mahabihar Bhikkhu Sanghasa. This is original photograph which I have taken from, you can say, Nalanda Museum. Again, so how, not in India, but outside India, just we have seen that in Pakistan in the Peshawar Kurram Valley. There is an inscription in the 1st century AD. But here from the internet I have tried to find out that how in Dule temple, in Chinese it is called as pinyin, Dule Si, and it literally means temple of solitary joy. So how ye dhamma hetu pavah, I have given the, you can say, transliteration of that, you can say, Chinese term of hetu, ye dhamma hetu pavah, hetum tesam tathagata hayavat, tesam cha yo nirodho evam badi mahasramana. So this is also written in the, you can say, bottom of the, you can say, inscription, but I am not able to find out what it is written, you can say. I am not aware of Chinese language. Again, in Tianjin, China, if you see in Chinese letters, there are two lines in the middle, which is written, Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava. So, I not remember, but for the sake of knowledge of amongst the August gathering, I am just showing you that this Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava in the Tianjin, China, it has been depicted like this.
What is the sculpture is
like? I am not able to, just above there is a statue, but I have tried to, you can say, collect it from the internet. So I am not aware of the, you can say, that what it does it signify. So just I am giving you for the sake of that historians may, you can say it, take up this research as a matter of, you can say. Again, in the Republic of Korea, there is a Bio National Museum. In Bio National Museum, we are seeing that how a monk is being blessed by, you can say, and in right side, we are having Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava in, you can say, Korean language. So in Korean language, Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava in Sanskrit form, I have not given the, you can say, transliteration of the Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava, which is written in the Korean language. So I have also collected it from the internet, and I have just giving you the information. Again, this Ye Dharma Hetu Pava in Sanskrit transliteration in Tibetan Yuchen script, it has been given, and how it has come into the, you can say, Lancha script, and how it has been transcribed in the Thangka. I will give you some of the slides on that. Ye Dhamma mantra is in cursive, semi-formal and formal version of the Lancha script of the verse Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava from a Tibetan Thangka. So there are three lines, you can say. So there are these three lines. One is the cursive, another is the semi-formal, and third is the formal. There are Tibetan experts who are sitting here, and they are aware of the Lancha script. They may be able to know that what it is written. So this Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava, it has been written in the form, you can say. Again, Ye Dharma in Lancha script, I have given in a very, you can say, I have also collected it from the internet. And this is the Sarda, you can say, Brahmi script, which is available in Sarnath, which has, was disappeared by Cunningham, Alexander Cunningham. So I have given you that how Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava, it has been written here. Now in Sri Lanka also, this Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava in the single language is the Pali, but in Sinhalese it has been written. So how it has been depicted, and how in the monasteries they have been, you can say, depicted outside the temple, I have. So this is the, now I'm coming to the conclusion part of the thesis, that Ye Dhamma Hetu Pava was the, you can say, one of the popular, you can say, epitome or the verse at the time of the Buddha also, and after the Mahaparinirvana of the Buddha. And this, you can say dharma, ye dharma hetu prabha was, you can say, kept in the bhoti vistupas or in the temples or the mahabiharas to give a, you can say, life, that is the pran pratistha, until unless this verse was not, you can say, kept in the bhotivastupa, in the form of the, you can say, in the temples, until unless there is no, you can say, pran or life in that mahabhyara. So this became much popular at the time of the Buddha. This formula became manifestation of the Buddha's law of dependent origination. It transformed the harmonizing the teachings of the Buddha also, and the engraving of the formula transformed Rupakaya as Dharmakaya or embodiment of the Dharma. So this is the my presentations. Thank you very much for patience hearing. Thank you very much.
Sir Vimalendra Kumar, the paper is open for discussion.
I think an excellent presentation like this cannot go without at least a laudation, you know. Yeah, it's wonderful, and you presented it so humbly, just saying, I do not know this, but I think you know almost everything. That you, because without knowing this, you cannot collate the whole, you know, subcontinental spread of all these findings. Am I right?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. I think from IIT Kharagpur, but in a system of IITs, we are trying to do some work in Ratnagiri. And the normal idea is everything flowed from Nalanda, and in Ratnagiri it originated much later, around 6th, 7th, 8th century AD or so. But the recent ideas which has emerged from recent exploratory archaeological evidences has taken the date much earlier. To what date, I won't say here because we don't have the final proof, but that takes Mahayana Buddhism almost right to the times of Buddha himself. Because there are archaeological evidences in Orissa going through the borders of Bangladesh and reaching Nalanda, which was probably coexistent with Nepal and Tibet from a very ancient point of time, almost commensurate with the time of Buddha himself. So in this respect, your findings are extremely important. It's open to future research and future evidences. Then we can come to a conclusion. So I think your presentation has to come to us. If you are kind enough, you can forward this presentation to us officially. You know,
thank
I say
you very
it.
Much. Yeah, yeah. Because of lack of time, I had to summarize all these things.
Yeah, yeah.
I had to say so many things related with all the inscriptions, but due to lack of time, I had to complete in a very, you can say, short time.
There's so much in your presentation.
Still, I have to collect so many informations which are not, you can say, available to me. So still much has to be accomplished in this.
And it is also very interesting and synonymous to discuss about Hetu Pravaha sitting in Jnana Pravaha.
Yes.
And the center of University of Tibetan Studies.
From Hetu Pravaha. Please, Shastri, your very interesting and very valuable presentation, especially on the Yadharma site, because many people doesn't understand, you know, all the, what is the, you know, stupa for a general public, which means where it contains a relic. Many of that are votive, which is the important things. The Yadharma is the important, you know, relic is there. And now I want to ask, yesterday as Pempa was a Bhava, as you have also come Bhava Chakra today, do you have anything like Bhava Chakra as we see in Ajanta cave number 17, that drawing, whether in Pali tradition is still intact? If it's so, then in the middle of that, yesterday in Dr. Pampa's, you know, presentation, we found that there was some variation of the three poisons that from the pig's mouth, both these comes, and there's another drawing we found that is a circular. Do you have anything in Pali literature, some kind of Bhava Chakra written somewhere?
Not,
have you found that?
No, till now I have not found out. Whatever the, you can say, the pig and the dog and snake.
Yeah,
I have not got the reference like that till.
मैं सर्वप्रथम डॉक्टर बिमल कुमार जी को मैं बधाई देता हूँ इस पेपर के लिए. मैं जानबूझ के हिंदी में बोल रहा हूँ क्योंकि कल किसी पेपर में कहा गया था और क्योंकि मैं हिंदी जानता हूँ थोड़ा बहुत तो मैं कहा कि मैं हिंदी में बोलूँ। मैं एक बात यहाँ पे एम्फेसिस करना चाहूँगा अपना पर्सनली, अगर मैं इस सेमिनार में नहीं आता तो शायद मैं बुद्धिज़्म के बहुत सारे ऐसे एस्पेक्ट्स हैं जो मैंने देखा है उसके प्रति मेरा विमोचन या मेरा आँख नहीं खुलता। आज मैं क्योंकि मैं 12 साल में औरंगाबाद में रहते हुए अपने सरकारी कामकाज में अजंता एलोरा को मैं 1000 से ज़्यादा बार मैं देखा हूँ। मैं अभी मेरे गुरुजी से कह रहा था कि इस प्रकार का एक सेमिनार मैं जो गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया को रिकमेंड करने जा रहा हूँ, जो आई एम ए रिटायर्ड पर्सन नाउ, कि इस प्रकार का एक सेमिनार अजंता जैसे जगह पर हो या औरंगाबाद में हो, जहाँ से अजंता और एलोराज में जहाँ पे पेंटिंग्स अवेलेबल है, पितलखोरा में पेंटिंग्स अवेलेबल है। कल मैंने एक छोटा सा हिस्सा आपको दिखाया था कि इसमें ये एक दूसरे के पर्याय हैं, आर्ट फिलॉसफी जो आज मैं देख रहा हूँ यहाँ पर, ये क्योंकि इन सबको वहाँ पे दर्शाने का, ये सिर्फ आर्टिस्ट के खुशी के हिसाब से सारे स्कल्पचर या पेंटिंग नहीं हुए, इनका जरूर कोई कारण रहा है। वो कारण किसने मांगा, किसने दिया और कितने भली भांति उसको उत्कीर्ण किया गया रॉक में, क्योंकि वो परमानेंट है, पेपर आदि गल जाते हैं तो वो परमानेंट है, चाहे भले वो बाद में किया हो। अभी बहुतेरे ऐसे एस्पेक्ट्स हैं जो पेंटेड भी हैं, चित्रित भी हैं और कार्व किए हुए हैं और जिसे हम रेखांचित्र कहते हैं उसमें भी हैं, जो अभी तक डिसाइफर नहीं किया गया है या उनका प्रॉपर स्टडी नहीं किया गया है, और इसके लिए ये अकेला एक आर्कियोलॉजिस्ट या आर्ट हिस्टोरियन नहीं कर सकता है, इसके लिए सम्मिलित एफर्ट होना जरूरी है। जैसा आपने बहुत भली भांति यहाँ दिखाया कि हे धम्म हेतु प्रवाह किस तरह से अलग अलग जगह पर इंक्लूडिंग चाइना, टिबेटन और अदर प्लेसेस, कोरिया वगैरह में पहुँचा है, वहाँ पर ये एक यूनिवर्सल ग्रांट ऑफ एक्नॉलेजमेंट, ये इसको एक्सेप्ट किया गया है, तो क्या ये सारा चीज़ बाकी के इसमें भी आया है। अब ये बात और भी आता है, क्या अजंता क्या एलोरा अपने आप में एक प्रतिकृति किसी कारणवश हुआ है या अपने आप में हुआ है, ये भी इसके ऊपर दर्शाने की बात आती है। इसमें मैं एक और चीज़ का मैं ये कहूँगा जो आपके टॉपिक से संबंधित नहीं है, परंतु कल आप लोगों ने देखा होगा यहाँ पे हमारे वयोवृद्ध और सभी रिस्पेक्टेड जो बुद्धिस्ट मंक्स बैठे हैं, क्या आपने कभी कोई ग्रीन रोब पहना है? कि हम जानते हैं बुद्ध इज़ ऑलवेज शोन इन ए भगवा कलर का, या जो आप आज पहने हैं उस प्रकार के इसमें, या सफ़ेद में ऐसे नज़र आते, क्या आपने कभी कोई ग्रीन कलर का रोब पहना है? इन कलर्स का भी कोई कारण है। मेरे पास यहाँ फोटो विद्यमान है, अजंता में एक ही केव में बुद्ध को काले रोब में भी दिखाया गया है, वाइट रोब में भी दिखाया गया है और भगवा कलर के रोब में भी दिखाया गया है। इसका एक क्या कारण हो सकता है? मैंने आपको जो कल दिखाया है धर्मचक्र प्रवर्तन मुद्रा स्टैंडिंग पोस्चर में, उसका अगर आप कलर देखेंगे तो जो कलर आज आपने परिधान में लिया हुआ है वो उसके अंदर दिखाया गया है। अगर मैं यहाँ पर आके इसको क्लोजली न डिस्कस करता, देखता, तो शायद मेरा आज एक नया उस पर्टिकुलर पेंटिंग के ऊपर सोचने के लिए मुझे बाध्य कर रहा है। ठीक है, उसमें इंस्क्रिप्शन कोई नहीं है, तो क्या यह पेंटिंग, हम इसको अजम्पशन ले सकते हैं कि टिबेट या उस तरफ से जो लोग आए हैं, जैसे दलाई लामा जी उधर से यहाँ पर आए या उस समय वहाँ थे, क्या वहाँ से कोई आके इसको डोनेट करके ये चित्रित करवाया है और उन्होंने कहा है कि नहीं, यहाँ बुद्ध को इस कलर में आप दिखाइए? क्या ये हो सकता है? क्योंकि ये अपने आप में अकेला एक उदाहरण है पूरे वेस्टर्न इंडिया में या जहाँ भी पेंटेड वर्शंस हैं उसमें, तो ये क्या कारण? क्योंकि काले रोब में बुद्ध मैं नहीं समझता हूँ आप में से किसी ने देखा है। हैव यू सीन एनी ऑफ यू? नाउ मैं अभी अपने गुरुजी को दिखा रहा था, मेरे पास बहुत दिन से मैं लिखना करके हुआ नहीं है, इसमें ये जस्ट वन मिनट एंड इसमें ये मदर एंड चाइल्ड के साथ में, दैट इज राहुल व्हेन ही विजिटेड कपिलवस्तु, वो दिखाया हुआ है, तो वहाँ पे काले रोब में उनको दिखाया गया है। ये अपने आप में एक यूनिकनेस है वहाँ पर। तो ये सारे जो चीज़ें हैं उसमें भी जरूर कोई फिलासफी छुपी है, तो क्या है वो फिलासफी, तो ये भी सारा चीज़ देखने के लिए हो सकता है। धन्यवाद।
ओनली ब्रीफ, टू ब्रीफ कॉमेंट्स, वन बाय प्रोफेसर भट्ट एंड द अदर बाय प्रोफेसर पेम्पा दोरजी।
जी, मेरा बस वही एक छोटा सा बात कहना है मुझे, कि जब अभी ये धर्म की बात चल ही रहा है, इसलिए मैं ये कहना चाहता था कि जब हम तीर्थ यात्रा पर जाते थे और म्यूज़ियम का जो अवलोकन करते थे, तो हमने ऐसा पाया कि बहुत सारे मूर्तियों के ऊपर के हिस्से में ये गोदा हुआ मिला कि ये धर्म हेतु प्रभाव वाला पूह। लेकिन जब हम उसको देख करके, हमें तो ये क्या कहते हैं कि अनुमान लगाया जा सकता है कि ये बौद्ध का कोई मूर्ति है, बौद्ध संबंधित कोई मूर्ति है। लेकिन जब उसकी जो नीचे कैप्शन देखता हूँ, तो कोई दूसरे नाम से उनके किया हुआ ऐसा बहुत मिलता है। तो आज जगह भी है और यहाँ सब आर्कोलॉजिस्ट बहुत सारे यहाँ जो धुरंधर लोग बैठे हैं, तो उनसे मेरा यही विनम्र निवेदन है कि उन क्षेत्रों में अगर इन सारे बातों को एक बार और दोबारा उनकी अवलोकन हो सके, उनको ठीक कर सके, तो बहुत ही अच्छा होगा। क्योंकि हम कुछ दिन पहले हम पटना म्यूज़ियम में थे, तो वहाँ भी ऐसे हुआ था। एक पटना म्यूज़ियम की जो मूर्तियों पर भी कुछ इस तरह के नाम्स थे, और एक बात था कि राहुल जी ने बहुत सारे थंकाएँ तिब्बत से लाए थे, तो वहाँ थंकाओं को डिस्प्ले किया हुआ था, तो उसमें भी जो उनकी जो क्या कहते हैं कि उसको चिन्हित करने में एक दो बार वहाँ भी थोड़ा गलतियाँ हुआ था। तो हम लोगों ने, हमारा पूरा टीम था, तो हम लोगों ने उनसे कहा कि इसमें यह होना चाहिए, इसमें यह होना चाहिए, और जो हमें खुद पता नहीं था, तो हमने कहा कि ये विशेषज्ञ से पूछना चाहिए। वो यही मेरा विनम्र निवेदन है। थैंक यू।
प्रोफेसर बापट ने 2500 ईयर्स ऑफ बुद्धिज़्म जो किताब एडिट करी है, उसमें एक जगह यह उल्लेख आया है कि चाइना में किसी एक स्थान पर बुद्धिस्ट मॉन्क्स जो हैं वो काले वस्त्र पहनते थे, तो संभवतः वो काला वहाँ से प्रभावित हुआ हो, ये एक संभावना है। हाँ, तो ये वो है ना। हाँ, तो ये एनीवे मेरा प्रश्न था।
थैंक यू।
आपने कहा तो याद है। हाँ,
पूरे मॉन्क्स का लेते हैं। हाँ।
सो थैंक यू प्रोफेसर भट्ट एंड थैंक यू प्रोफेसर भट्ट।
अच्छा, मेरे प्रश्न तो रही
है। नहीं, प्रश्न था, प्लीज बी ब्रीफ।
वो ये कि आपने प्रतीत समुत्पाद के प्रत्ययता वाले पक्ष को ले लिया, निस्वभावता वाले पक्ष को भी स्पर्श किया, विस्तार से तो नहीं किया, लेकिन तीसरा जो था परस्पराश्रयता, जो कि महायान का बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण पक्ष है, उसको आपने स्पर्श नहीं किया, वो बड़ा इम्पोर्टेंट है।
और जो नॉट हिज मेन पॉइंट,
आई हैड टू कंसंट्रेट माई सेल्फ ओनली ऑन ये धर्म हेतु प्रभा, एंड लेटर ऑन आई हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस दैट हाउ बुद्ध एंड यू कैन से प्रतिसमुत्पाद और प्रतिसमुत्पाद हैज यू कैन से रिलेटेड टुगेदर विथ मध्यमा और यू कैन से शून्यता, सो दैट पार्ट आई हैव नॉट यू कैन से टेकन, अदरवाइज व्हाट यू आर टेलिंग देर माइट बी अनदर पेपर ऑन दैट आस्पेक्ट ऑल्सो, सो थैंक यू।
प्रोफेसर भट्ट हैज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट देर कुड बी डिफरेंट कंसेप्शंस ऑफ प्रतीत्य समुत्पाद एंड हेतु, वन बेस्ड ऑन हेतु प्रत्यय, हेतु प्रभुवत्व, एंड द अदर बेस्ड ऑन परस्पराश्रयत्व, निस्वभावत्व, एंड वेदर दे आर दे कैन बी डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम ईच अदर और दे आर डिफरेंट इंडिपेंडेंट कंसेप्शंस, दैट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, बट दैट विल टेक अस टू फार, सो मे बी इंडिपेंडेंटली वी हैव टू डिस्कस दीज इश्यूज़। in some other seminar or in some other session. So with this, I congratulate both the paper presenters. They have done an excellent job, and I also thank all the participants or the discussants who participated in the discussion. So this session is over. We will disperse for tea and come back within 10 minutes or so. Thank you. The tea is available in the next room.